With me, Pallavi. Now, as you all know, I am an avid traveler. I love traveling, I think the most in life. And so this year for my birthday, I had kind of put my foot down that I am going to Spain for my birthday and I'm going to Europe and I don't care if anybody else comes along or not. So thankfully, I finally got my way and my family came along with me and we had a great 2 weeks in Europe and I just wanted to share that with you. So we're going to start off with the first of this series and we're going to start off with my favorite place where I celebrated my birthday, which is Amsterdam. So here's a quick video just to show you what all I experienced, what all you can do when you're planning your trip to Amsterdam. So I hope you enjoy this and make sure you give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel for lots more and don't forget to hit that bell icon, please. Tell me in your comments if you enjoy this video and what more you'd like to see. But first, let me show you my trip in Amsterdam. Hey guys, welcome to Amsterdam. So we're in the Albert Cuyp Market right now in the Pipe area. That's the tram station we got off at and this is like one of those really local slash touristy markets. So there's lots and lots of fresh troop waffles everywhere which are very unique to Amsterdam. These are these lovely caramel and chocolate coated fresh waffles. So you'll find these everywhere. You'll also find some really nice fish at so many stalls, some really nice grilled chicken and the usual trinkets. But this is something really cute that I just spotted while I was walking down this market and I'm gonna go check it out, so come along. And it's right in the middle of the market, which is an open market, and suddenly you have this really warm, cozy, old style building. Just check out the world of this. And of course, no day on a trip is complete without a drink, so let's get one. And we're exploring the floating flower market today. There's a whole variety of tulips everywhere you see, and also we're here in tulip season. So there are lovely tulips in full bloom. There are wooden tulips for sale. There are tulip starter kits. According to them, you can buy these bulbs and take them anywhere in the world and grow your own tulips. It's just a lovely place to be. Lots and lots of fresh flowers everywhere. So let's look. Travel guides or blogs that you'll go through will tell you to just get lost in the lanes and not follow the map, and for somebody like me it's very difficult to do. I need to know where I'm going and what. But right now we started off in Jordan and now we've made our way somewhere into Harlem because we're looking for great pizza. So I think you really need to follow those guides, and it is fun to just come into one area and let yourself get led by these beautiful streets. Like, we just saw this beautiful plant, so we've just walked into this street and it's just so much fun to just spend a day. So pick a neighborhood, that is the way to go for it. So pick a neighborhood that matches your interest and then just loiter around the streets and you'll discover such amazing places like this gelato guy.
said that, there is still some charm to this place. Usually every evening there will be some of the other street performer here. You'll have lots of those living statues that you've seen. You'll have some music performances. We just saw an amazing magic show. Not really a magic show, but just there are lots and lots of amazing street performers. And this place is just hustling and bustling. Lots of tourists, lots of cheese shops, lots of goodies to eat. So you must come to Dam Square and just spend half a day walking around this area. Walk right up to the central station and walk right back. And that should take care of good one day. So this right here is the Amsterdam Central Station, and this is where you get your connections for anywhere and everywhere you want to go around the city. You have trains which are interstate, you have the metro, you have trams, buses, canals, everything originates from here. And the best thing you can do for yourself is to pick up one of these GVB travel ticket cards. So for however long you're here, you can pick up a ticket for 1 hour, for a day, 2 days, 3 days, up to 7 days you can pick up these tickets. And it's so handy because you can use this across all medium of transport except for the canal. So you can just hop into any tram and, you know, just go anywhere. Okay, I like this place, I like this restaurant, I'm just gonna get off. So it's the easiest way to travel because Amsterdam is a very small city. You can also do most of it on foot, but it's just so convenient to use this public transport system and just hop on and hop off wherever you like. Another one must do here in Amsterdam is to take this ferry to the north of Amsterdam. Now this is an area which most tourists end up missing out, and in fact I'm also going there for the first time. There are some really cool bars over there to hang out. So this is a ferry that you get from the back of the central station. Make sure you take the one going towards NDSM, and the best part is that this is a free ferry. So if you're not doing one of the canal cruises, you can just do this and still be out on the water and experience Amsterdam by the waters, which is the best way to experience Amsterdam in my opinion. So we're headed there. Shipyard, which is converted into this very cool hippy-dippy neighborhood. We're heading into Plek right now, which is one of the best cafes around this area. So let's go see. This is apparently really, really happening on the weekends. Everybody sits out when there's a bright sun out. You can just sit, have a nice meal, have some drinks, and just sit by the canal, by the river, and enjoy. Hired a private boat, a self-drive boat from this company called Mokum Boat. There are plenty of these companies. A really cool one that I spotted was Those Damn Boat Guys, Rent a Boat. There's lots of them, just search online. This particular company charges 95 euros for 2 hours. I initially thought that 2 hours is too long, but after having just almost completed the trip, I feel that 2 hours is the bare minimum that you need. It's a really fun way to explore the city, just to discover everything. You can have your own party as long as the captain stays sober. Everybody can drink. There's no loud music allowed, but just carry your chips and just chunk. And it's like a really, really great way to celebrate. I'm celebrating my birthday here on the canal today. And I think it's something you must definitely do if you're trying to do something special in Amsterdam. So yesterday we visited the Albert Cuyp Market, which is one of the largest local markets around here, and that was really fun. It was very interesting. There were lots of fresh vegetables and fruits. Today we've come to this market called Waterloo Plain Market, and this does not really compare to that. This is a very local kind of a flea market. There's mostly like old junk and like used shoes and jackets and those kinds. So there are plenty of flea markets all over Amsterdam, so you don't really need to go to all of those, pick and choose the right ones. Albert Cuyp is more touristy, but there's lots more interesting stuff. I'm not too happy about this one. So amidst the many, many squares in Amsterdam, we are right now at Rembrandtplein. So this is a really nice happening area. You can see the statue of Rembrandt and lots of war statues behind, which is obviously a great tourist spot. Lots of people taking pictures of the statues. But all in all, this area is quite expensive. I actually found this area to be more expensive than the central area. There's lots of fries, lots of nice bars. The typical European style of having a big square and restaurants with chairs and tables all around it. It's a lovely place to sit and just enjoy maybe some occasional live music or something. Just sit, have a drink and watch people go by. So I hope that video was helpful for you. I hope you got some nice tips for your next trip to Amsterdam. And please leave me comments. Tell me what more you'd like to see from me. Until next time, keep coming back. And if you haven't hit that bell icon yet, please do so you don't miss out on anything. Thank you for joining me. I'll be back with lots more soon. Bye.